Okay, so the question is, what are the main ACLS drugs? Well, I can basically break them into three categories. You have your pressors, your antiarrhythmics, and your others. Starting with the pressor. For example, epinephrine. Epinephrine is the first drug we would administer during a cardiac arrest. And epinephrine has properties of both beta stimulation and alpha stimulation. Beta gets the heart to beat harder, stronger, faster, and alpha stimulation helps the blood vessels to constrict to raise blood pressure. And in fact, that's why we give it first in a cardiac arrest, is to help more blood and oxygen and nutrients get back to the heart. So those are pressors. After an arrest, we may give another type of pressor just to support their blood pressure, like dopamine, levofed, another type of pressor. Next category, antiarrhythmics. And these are drugs that are administered to treat a particular ECG arrhythmia, most often ventricular in nature in a cardiac arrest. So we're looking at ventricular arrhythmias. One drug we would administer, an antiarrhythmic, would be amiodarone. Our first dose for that in a cardiac arrest, 300 milligrams, slam it, get it to the heart quickly. It can also be used in a stable patient by giving a slow infusion. Another popular antiarrhythmic is lidocaine. The dose there is 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. Again, slam bolus followed with a flush to get it to the heart. The third category is other. And other drugs treat very specific issues with the patient. For example, let's say we have an ECG that looks like this. This is torsades de pointes. The treatment for this is magnesium, because most often torsades is caused by a low magnesium level. If we look at this rhythm, we have these peak T waves. Well, this is hyperkalemia, so we would administer calcium chloride. So you have your pressors, your antiarrhythmics, and then your other drugs used to treat very specific issues with the patient.
Important stuff. Issues.
Now, quickly, I just broke the drugs down into three categories: pressors, antiarrhythmics, and others. But there are quite a few drugs that we use in ACLS. Now, throughout our didactic and our video training program, we're going to cover these drugs. We're going to cover the indications and dosages for all the ACLS drugs that we use. I'm Mark. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in class.